This is Optimal Work Daily, episode 1239, 7 Ways to Make Meetings More Efficient, by Brian Tracy of briantracy.com. And I'm Dan, I'm your host here, and I'm with you every single day to help you optimize your work life. And we're going to jump right into it now as we hear from one of our regular authors, Brian, and optimize your life. 7 Ways to Make Meetings More Efficient, by Brian Tracy of briantracy.com. Meetings are the third major time waster in the world of work. As much as 50% of working time is spent in meetings, either group meetings or one-on-one meetings. In the estimate of almost everyone, at least 50% of this time is wasted. This means that as much as 25% of all working time is lost in meetings of one kind or another. However, meetings are not an evil. Meetings are a necessary business tool for exchanging information, solving problems, and reviewing progress, but they must be managed and they must be used effectively to avoid them succumbing to Parkinson's law. Here are 7 ways to increase the efficiency and improve the results of meeting time. Number 1, is the meeting necessary? Many meetings turn out, in retrospect, to be unnecessary. There are other ways to achieve the same goal. Some things you can achieve by circulating a memo. You can have a conference call. You can speak to people individually. You can even postpone it to another meeting or another time altogether. If a meeting is not necessary, avoid holding it whenever possible. If the meeting is necessary, then ask, is it necessary for me to attend this meeting? If it is not necessary for you to attend, don't go in the first place. If it is not necessary for someone else to attend a particular meeting, make sure that he knows he does not have to be there. 2, write an agenda. If you have determined that the meeting is necessary, establish a clear purpose for the meeting and write up an agenda. An excellent time management tool is for you to write a one-paragraph statement of purpose for the meeting. Start with this sentence, "We are having this meeting to achieve this specific goal." Then write out the objective of the meeting. This is a tremendous discipline. Make out an agenda or a list of everything that has to be covered in the meeting. Next to each item, put the name of the person who's expected to address that particular issue. Distribute the agenda, if possible, at least 24 hours in advance so that each person knows what she will be expected to contribute. You want everyone to know what the objective of the meeting is and what will be discussed. This applies to one-on-one meetings with your boss, with your subordinates, with your customers, with your suppliers, and whoever else. 3, start and stop on time. Set a schedule for the beginning of the meeting and set a time for the end of the meeting. If the meeting is going to run from 8 until 9, start it at 8 o'clock sharp and end it at 9 o'clock sharp. The worst types of meetings are the ones that start at a specific time but have no clearly determined ending time. Here's another rule. Don't wait for the latecomer. Assume the latecomer is not coming at all and start at the designated time. It is unfair to punish the people who are on time by making them wait for the person who gets there late, if at all. Many companies establish the policy of locking the meeting room from the inside at the exact time the meeting is scheduled to start. The people who show up late are not allowed in. You can be sure that they don't show up late the next time. 4, cover important items first. When you draw up the agenda, apply the 80-20 rule. Organize the agenda so that the top 20% of items are the first items to be discussed. This way, if you run out of time, you will have covered the items that represent 80% of the value of the meeting before the time runs out. 5, summarize each conclusion. When you discuss each item on your meeting agenda, summarize the discussion and get closure. Get agreement and completion on each item before you go on to the next one. Restate what has been decided upon and agreed to with each item before you proceed. 6, assign specific responsibility. If you have made a decision, assign responsibility for the specific actions agreed upon and set deadlines. Remember, discussion and agreement without an assignment of responsibility and a deadline for the completion is merely a conversation. Be clear about who is going to do what and when. And 7, keep notes and circulate minutes. A key to getting maximum effectiveness from meetings is to keep accurate notes and to circulate the minutes of the meeting within 24 hours whenever possible. The person who keeps accurate minutes from a meeting that can be pulled out a week or a month later can resolve a lot of potential misunderstandings. Agendas prepared in advance, followed by meeting minutes prepared shortly afterward, ensure that everyone is clear about his agreed-upon responsibilities and deadlines. You just listened to the post titled 7 Ways to Make Meetings More Efficient by Brian Tracy of briantracy.com. You want consistency and quality, but you also want variety and freshness. If you run a business, you want it all. With nuts.com, you can get so many different delicious snacks and ingredients and know that they will consistently exceed your expectations. Nuts.com is your one-stop shop for the highest quality foods for business. They offer delicious office snacks, corporate gifts, and wholesale ingredients. And over 50,000 companies choose nuts.com for their business needs, from offices to hotels to restaurants and retail stores. And we've even loved their product as remote workers. Nuts.com has sent us plenty of snacks that keep us energized and focused so we can deliver the best work that we can. Nuts.com makes ordering for your business quick and easy. Right now, Nuts.com is offering new business customers a free gift with purchase and free shipping on orders of $125 or more at nuts.com/OWD. So go check out all the delicious options at nuts.com/OWD. You'll get that free gift and free shipping when you spend $125 or more. That's nuts.com/OWD. Your business is buried in manual work, taking forever to close the books. If this is you, consider 3 numbers: 37,000, 25, 1. 37,000, that's the number of businesses who have upgraded to NetSuite by Oracle. 25, NetSuite turns 25 this year. That's 25 years of helping businesses do more with less, close their books in days, not weeks, and drive down costs. And 1, because your business is one of a kind, so you get a customized solution for all of your KPIs in one efficient system with one source of truth. Manage risk, get reliable forecasts, and improve margins. NetSuite is giving you the power of having everything you need to grow all in one place. And you really can't put a price on the power and efficiency that comes with having all of your processes streamlined like this. This is truly an unprecedented offer. Right now, download NetSuite's popular KPI checklist, designed to give you consistently excellent performance, absolutely free at netsuite.com/OWD. That's netsuite.com/OWD to get your own KPI checklist. netsuite.com/OWD. And a big thank you to Brian, who is chairman and CEO of Brian Tracy International, which helps people achieve personal and business goals quickly and easily. He has studied, researched, written, and spoken for 30 years in the fields of economics, history, business, philosophy, and psychology, and Brian is the top-selling author of over 70 books. His talks and seminars on leadership, selling, self-esteem, goals, strategy, creativity, and success psychology are super effective in creating both immediate changes and long-term results. Brian is also active in community and national affairs and is the president of 3 companies headquartered in Solana Beach, California. So come on by his site, briantracy.com, to learn a lot more, and he's actually narrated across all of our podcasts. So if you like his content and you like his style, just check out our other shows, and you can do that by searching for Optimal Living Daily wherever you're hearing this. So that is it for another edition of Optimal Work Daily. I hope you enjoyed this post, and I'll be back again with you tomorrow, where your optimal life awaits.